Hi friends, this is Funny. Today we are going to be talking about cyanide compounds. The characteristics of cyanide compounds. Potassium cyanide and sodium cyanide, both white crystalline and granular powders. Hydrogen cyanide is volatile and colorless liquid. Cyanide gas is highly flammable and reacts violently in some situations. Hydroscopic and water reactive. Faint almond-like odor. Cyanide salts are used in metallurgy for electroplating, metal cleaning, and in organic synthesis reaction. Hazards associated with cyanide compounds. The main hazards are corrosive, poisonous, danger to aquatic organisms, and flammable for HCN gas only. The symptoms of cyanide exposure are seen rapidly and include headache, nausea, vomitings, and elevated breathing and heart rates. With suitable dose, these symptoms can quickly progress to loss of consciousness, respiratory failure, and death. What happens when a person is poisoned with cyanide? Upon ingestion, it binds to hemoglobin, the molecule in red blood cells responsible for carrying oxygen to the cells in our body. Hemoglobin then ferries it into body tissues, where it can bind to an enzyme called cytochrome oxidase. This enzyme is a vital tool cells required to make use of oxygen, and with cyanide bound to it, they are unable to use oxygen. Treatment for cyanide exposure. There is no universally agreed method for treating cyanide poisoning, and different treatments are favored in different countries. Most prevalent antidotes are nitrates, which converts hemoglobin to methemoglobin, which then removes cyanide from cytochrome oxidase enzyme. Thiosulfates are commonly administered in combination with nitrates, as they help convert the cyanide to thiocyanate, which can then be eliminated from the body through urine. In case of exposure, check the eye pupil color. If the exposure victim is breathing, then put the broken tablet of methyl nitrite near patient's nose 5 times at an interval of 15 minutes. If the exposure patient is not breathing, then give artificial breathing to until the patient begins to breathe, and seek medical attention immediately. Safe handling of cyanides. Provide safety data sheets to employees and other workers who may be exposed to cyanide at the workplace. Ensure containers containing cyanide are correctly labeled. Ensure that the contents of any pipework or process vessels containing cyanide are adequately identified. Handle the chemical only by wearing appropriate PPE, respiratory protection, hand gloves, and gum shoes. Ensure cyanide is stored in closure container Keep workplaces and stores dry and well ventilated. Ensure that acid chemicals cannot accidentally come in contact with cyanide. Sodium cyanide must not be stored in any place where acids, nitrates stored, or acidic gases may be generated. Keep potassium permanganate or caustic lye solution ready for charging sodium cyanide bags. Ensure HCN detectors, local exhaust ventilation, and scrubber in working condition before starting the sodium cyanide charging operation. Before taking cyanide from drum, first remove the lid, then move away to let the accumulated gas out from the container before returning to handle the cyanide. In case of fire, cyanide salts or solution are not combustible but may generate highly toxic, flammable, corrosive and explosive hydrogen cyanide gas if in contact with water and acidic agents. If a fire occurs in the vicinity of cyanide, evacuate the area immediately and call emergency services. Use air-supplied breathing apparatus and full protective clothing to rescue anyone overcome by the poisonous gases or trapped by the fire. Use an extinguishing agent suited to the surrounding fire. However, avoid incompatible extinguishing agents like water, carbon dioxide coming into contact with the cyanide. Cyanides can react with the water or acids to produce the highly poisonous and flammable cyanide gas, which presents a very high risk of explosion. Use appropriate extinguish media. Let us summarize this session of cyanide compounds. Cyanide is fast-acting, bitter-tasting poison and one of the deadliest known. All forms of cyanides are poisonous, whether it is in solid form, dissolved as liquid or given off as HCN gas. Treat it with respect by knowing the risks and proper handling techniques. Friends, that's the end of this section. Watch my next presentation on chlorine. Keep watching and don't forget to subscribe my channel and have a safe day.